was running with the boat. Little dude
hit it like a freight train. That tells me one thing, George. Fish are hungry.
One-eyed catfish. He looks like, well, he's gonna be blind now.
Blinker.
Okay, that's the second one in like 10 minutes. I didn't get the first one. Didn't even have it set up, so we both got one within 5 minutes. So this is the third. We gotta hit the clicker. One, two. Okay, we're three on the clicker. Get this guy back. That guy took it down good. Ooh, jumper. Fish number four. Smash that head. The golden channel cats. Mike Chavez said he likes to see those goldens. He's pulling the boat
now. Crank down.
Another good one, guys.
Like, yeah, that one, back. Boy. That's a nice fatty. Yeah. Good Lord, George, look at that fish.
Three in a row, he swallowed it. Shit.
That guy took it down.
He just
like
inhaled it.
Was on the end of your line.
Yeah, he just inhaled it and then boogied with it. Man, he didn't even give me a chance.
Hey, look at that thing. Oh, there goes one of my legs.
Doubled up.
Just taking my rod down back to the tree.
Doubled up.
Bouncing all over.
That's two on the same head. There's a golden channel. It's number five. Oh,
he came off.
He's
serious?
Yeah, well, I picked him up. Oh, shit. I picked him up out of the water, so you can count him, I think.
Okay. The water temp's 42.
I pulled him up out of the water. He was right about to come in the boat.
You need to be over the gunwale, man.
So technically, I did pull him out.
But over the gunwale.
Oh, okay, so that would not count. Man, it has to be in. Sorry, George. Yeah.
I bet you they pulled that bait on the southern rod.
Yeah, it feels good on the slide action. He feels like a whale. I know he's not that big, but the light action sure does make him feel a lot heavier.
Fresh bait. I just loaded that up. That is number 10.
Number 10? Let's check that fish out, bro.
Oh man, hooked on. Pulling a little drag there.
I got a 15-pound monofilament leader to my hook. I do have the 65-pound braid. My main line, which is extremely strong, tough, and can handle a state record. But that 15-pound mono, I just really need to make sure that I have my drag set so that I don't break off. So far, I haven't caught a fish that'll come close to breaking that 15-pound, but there are some good fish in here, folks. Oh, I think I might be crossed with you, bro. Sorry about that. Just threw these two rods in.
They were barely down tightened up the line, yeah. Barely got the lines tightened
up. Yeah, baby. George, what are you doing over there, man? Catching a nice one, bro. Look at that one. That's the biggest one of the day so far, man.
I hope he starts staying this way.
Yeah, look at that fish.
On his belly.
Let's get a picture with these two together. Oh, look at this one. Nice. All right.
This is number 12, and that's number 13.
So I'm talking about, baby.
Birdie. Pretty fish.
Never a dull day fishing with George here. Oh, shit. Good takedown, boy.
Got that head.
Look like a blue takedown.
I got that little head. Man. You're just strong.
Strong, feisty little cold fish. February, folks. It's cold. Well, it's actually beautiful out here today.
Look at all the mud on this guy.
Ooh, is that fish turn right there? Oh, it's a good-sized fish. Whatever that was.
All right. This is number 14. Dinker butt. The other one back in the water. Just baited it up and the second rod went down. 15. Close to the boat. I tried just throwing it out.
Right under us.
Yeah. Okay, we're at 17. This would be 18.
Number 18?
18.
Loose. Yeah, and not that whole time. George, man, good job, dude. Kicking ass.
This guy's here. He wants it. He's not committing.
That was a takedown like a blue, man.
As soon as I put
one.
The damn rod down,
that thing bent your rod.
He decided he wanted it.
I know you like them rods. That they got nice flex. What type of rod is that again?
George, these are a slime cat striper, medium striper rods. They're perfect for channel cat, man. I mean, look at that flex.
That takedown looks awesome. That fish right there.
Those ugly stick catfish. They're too stiff. You can use those things for flatheads. Well, you did.
Yeah.
You got that 30 plus.
Yeah, I've just been with ugly sticks so long.
Hey, there's a.
Much. They're so reliable.
That one's almost portable. 10.
But those are some nice rods there. I really did like the flex on that fish.
Got old one whisker here. That one whisker chewed off or something. So this here, number 20.
Number 20. There's another one right there on your rod. See? Just smashed that rod down.
Yeah, that line was starting to go off to the right. I was like, he's got to be on there.
Maybe we ought to open up some, a betting website where you go live and everybody bets on the fish that which rod's going to catch the next fish.
Right? Right. Number 21.